So in this Microsoft PowerPoint 2016 tutorial video, we will talk about how to do head rigging using the Morph transition and action buttons. Hello everyone, this is Rajiv and welcome back to our channel. So as we are going to do head rigging in PowerPoint 2016, or you can also call it head shift. So here is the presentation I have, and this presentation contains 9 slides, as you can see here in the thumbnail view, and you can also note down the total number of slides from right here. I am standing at first slide, that is why it is showing slide 1 of 9, and if I click on any other slide, then you can notice the number down here. So this is a very simple animation that I created using the Morph transition and action buttons. So let's get started. And first of all, I would like to show you all the objects that I have used in this presentation. So for that, you can go to the Home tab, click the Select drop-down button and choose Selection Path. And here you can see all the objects that I have drawn here in this slide. And the similar objects can be seen on all the other slides. So the only difference that you can find from one slide to another is the direction of the head. So as you can see on the second slide, that the direction is a little bit downwards, and on the third slide it is right at the bottom, and on the fourth slide it is on the left side, on the fifth slide it is on the right side, on the sixth slide it is on the top right side, and on the seventh slide it is bottom right. 8th slide it is top left, and on the 9th slide it is bottom left. So I did nothing but just change the direction of these objects, and I have drawn these objects using the shape tool. And as you can see, that rounded corner rectangle has been used for the background, and you can use the yellow handler to change the shape size. And for this top here, you can do this trick. You can draw a oval here and then draw a rectangle over the oval, and then just subtract the oval from the rectangle by selecting both of these shapes by holding the shift key, then go to merge shapes and then use subtract command. You can also then draw another rounded corner rectangle on the end of this shape to make it look like this. And later you can choose shape outline, no outline, and choose the desired color for both of these objects. And later you can select both of these objects and then go to merge shapes from the shape format tab and then click union. That way it will make it a single object. So I have drawn all these shapes using the shape tool. You can watch my playlist on shape tools to learn more about how to draw inside PowerPoint 2016. So let's move further, and here as you can see that I have just changed the position of the objects. So on the first slide, we will talk about this head move direction settings. So this is an outer rectangle and these are the direction, as you can see in the selection pan. So what you have to do, you have to draw this character on the first slide and all these direction buttons on the first slide as well. And then after drawing all these objects, what you have to do, you have to duplicate the first slide by right clicking on it and then choose duplicate slide. And on the second slide, just move the shape, and then you can choose that on which button you want to apply the action. So as this head is moving left, so I will select this left dot, we'll go to the insert tab, and then we'll click the action button. And here what I want to do, I want to move to the another slide when someone click on this button. So it is asking you that by default it is set to none. That means no action will be done if you click or move over this button. But what I want to move to the particular slide, and for that you can click on the hyperlink drop down button and choose slide. And here you can choose which slide you want to move to when someone click or mouse over on that particular button. So let's say I want to choose fifth slide, hit the OK key and then again hit the OK key. You can also set the same action setting for mouse over as well. Go to mouse over tab, then choose hyperlink to, and then choose the slide you want to link to. Hit the OK key, and you can also make a check mark on highlight when mouse over and highlight when clicked. However, that doesn't make any sense while slideshow, but still if you want to enable them, you can see a little bit animation during the click or mouse over. So hit the OK key. So to create this entire animation, what you have to do, you have to duplicate the slide, first slide, and then change the head directions where you want them to, and then apply the action setting on the very first slide. So that way you have to apply the action setting on all these buttons. But let me clear you one thing, that let me copy this slide and open a new presentation and paste it right here and delete this one. Let me change the background. So one thing that you should keep in mind, that you should draw all these action buttons in the end. First of all, you have to draw the character, then duplicate the slide, then change the directions, then again make a duplicate of the slide, and again change the directions. Let me make it one more duplicate, and this time I'm going to move it down. Sorry, so this time I'm moving it a little bit down, let's say like this. And now what I will do, I will go to the first slide and will draw different dots here, let's say 4 dots. And on this second button, I would like to apply an action. On click, move to a particular slide, let's say second slide. This one for third slide, go to the actions, hyperlink to, slide, third slide. And this one for the fourth. And this one for the first slide. So if I click here, then it is changing the direction, but you can see that all the dots are gone now. So after applying actions on all the button at the very first slide, what you have to do, you have to select all these dots, go to the home tab, click copy, and then go to the second slide, click paste, third slide paste, and fourth slide paste. So that way you don't have to apply actions on each slide for each particular button. So it will copy all the actions on all the slides. So let me show you the slideshow again. So that is our very first slide. If I move here, if I click here, then the direction will go right there. So that is the easy way to replicate the actions on all the slides. Make sure to apply actions on all the objects on the very first slide, and then replicate all those objects on all the slides. The last thing you need to do before you see the slideshow is to select all these slides. Go to the transition tab and apply the morph effect. So, and then you can also decide the duration of each animation, each transition. Go to the slideshow, and now you can see that it will move faster. So the speed is totally up to you. So if I go to the first slide, then you can see that after creating 9 of these slides, in the end I draw all these direction buttons here, then applied the action on each button individually on the very first slide. Then after doing this, I selected all these action buttons, go to the home tab, copy, and then I pasted all of them one by one on each slide. And after that, selecting all the slides from the very first slide, hold down the shift key and then select the last slide and go through the transition tab, click the morph effect and set the timings. So before ending this lesson, I would also like to give you another tip here, that if you don't want to show these action buttons on the slide, then what you can do, you can delete all these action buttons, go to the insert tab, click shapes, and then draw a shape here. And what I want to do, I want to apply an action on this oval here. So on mouse click, I want to hyperlink this button to a particular slide, let's say 7th slide. And I also want to do this for the mouse over, particular slide, 7th slide, highlight mouse, click and hit the OK key. So that way you can draw different ovals or different shapes around this object. And when the user will see the slideshow and will move their mouse over these objects, then it will animate them without their knowledge that how this head is moving around. So I hope you will like this tutorial. Let me know by liking, sharing and commenting on this video. And do subscribe to our channel for more upcoming tutorial videos. Thanks for watching and have a great day.